Hello guys, and welcome to another review. Today I have finally finished off my collection of Logitech and brought a keyboard. Let's hope I don't scratch it. This is a live unboxing, so see how this goes. So, in your box, you just get another box. Let's throw that away. Looking good. This is brand new. Got off Amazon. UK layout. That's the thing, it's quite hard to find a UK layout. Rattle noise, yeah. But it's not quite hard to find, but to get a cheap one. Like on eBay, they're all US. A lot of them are US. They're cheap, but they come from the US, so it's pretty useless. So yeah, not much to say really. Nice packaging. You've got your details on the side. Windows 7, Vista, Windows 8. Ooh, Windows 8. Two high-speed USB 2. So it must be quite old, as it doesn't have USB 3. Internet connection for software download. I'll just show you that. Cool. On the back, got 1, 2, 3, 4. So, if you can read this, it says 110 key anti-ghosting, 26 key rollover, game design, game/desktop mode, dedicated media controls. That's number one. Adjustable dual zone backlighting. High speed, low noise tactile switching for feedback that you can feel. Wow. I'm guessing that's what the plus is compared to the other one. Six programmable keys. And 3-year warranty. And manufacturer's guarantee. Interesting. Quite looking forward to this. Make a change. As you can see, I've got SteelSeries, very old, but amazing. Gamepad, bit really bad for transport and stuff like that. So let's open it up. Hop, hop, and away. I don't want to damage the box. Make them so hard to get into. I've done that perfectly. I'll sell it on. I'm done today. Sell it on eBay for double the price I bought it for and see if an idiot buys it. Yay. There we go. Okay, cool. So I'm guessing this box just slides out as they normally do with other products. Yeah. Ooh, a box in a box. It's a total of 3 boxes. Zoom, zoom, zoom. There you go. Okay. Let's see what you get then. Oh, wait, no, more plastic. So it's a box within a box within a box with some sellotape and then some sticky circles and then some more sticky circles. I don't see why this would matter if it's stuck down. Could just come like that as you put it inside a box. But you know, maybe it's part of their packing process. Ooh, nice. That is nice. It's a lot smaller. That's the main thing I was going for. Its size. Its size does matter. So, let's see what you get. You obviously get the main keyboard, all your manuals, mechanical gaming, keyboard, setup guide, important information. get the keyboard. Oh, and a beast cable. That is very big. Take this box away, see what else you get in here. See if there's anything else. Some cardboard. And what that does. Rest. So, very simple. Let's see. On the outside of the box it says what you get included with it, so let's double check I have everything. You should get included in the box keyboard, palm rest, and user documentation. Okay. It's all there then. So one thing you first notice is two USBs. So I don't know if you'll be able to see this. Velcro. I thought it was going to be one of them annoying key wraps, but it's not, it's Velcro. Just like the same one that comes on the webcam. So on here, yep, I saw in a previous video. So you see here it has the keyboard, and then here it has the USB. So it's going to take two of your USBs up, but then it is going to be high speed. So with this keyboard, you're going to get your two inputs, but you obviously have your two USBs up here. So all the power is going through one cable, coming through all this, and then two ports, whereas with this, your ports will be getting the same power as they would through a computer. So that's one advantage already. It's very nice. I don't think there's going to be much to say on this except from I love it. Da, 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 da. So we're just saying about a box inside a box. So it's a box inside a box inside a box with some plastic stickers on. Inside plastic. I'm surprised they haven't done, or else I'm just a fool and missing it, but yeah, they have done a peel off. Oh well, no, I will peel off. I'm being very delicate, not. Dun dun dun. Already 7 minutes, I've not even fucking unboxed it yet. It's beautiful. It's very heavy, but it's smaller, which is one of the main reasons I have to upgrade. I don't know if I like this though. The rest. So I got the rest. I don't know what would be better actually. No, it's got to have the rest, hasn't it? Turn it over very gently, not. And put the rest in. See, this is very dinty, and from past experience, rests don't tend to last that long. Okay, so what you can see is, let's see where the USB ports are. USB ports are nowhere to be seen. I don't. Oh, it's right next to it, so you can see. USB port is there, and then what you've got. Is you have, you can obviously plug it in there and you can lead it if it's like a mouse. You can lead it out the keyboard through these grooves here. This one here. And this one up here. But it does feel nice and sturdy. That's gonna get greasy, isn't it? Yeah, so first impressions. Oh, it's very different. It's more. Can kind of see the curve rise up, whereas this one's very just flat. Keys, I don't know about these keys, I think they're a bit far away. But you've also got your gaming button. I'll zoom in on this here. Dun, dun, dun. Okay, that's full zoom. Okay, well, that didn't make much difference at all, did it? But I'll go ahead. Get it plugged in, powered on, and let's see how it goes. Let's see how this goes. Ooh, there you go. So as you can see, it's very bright. My camera doesn't want to zoom in on it. No, no, let's see. If I can work this out then, I'm guessing it's one of these. No. Ah, that's clever. Show you that in a minute. One, two, three. Okay. So it's still on there. So let's see. I don't know how well you can see this. Let's try zooming in again. Doesn't do much. Let's manually zoom. Manual zoom. Da da da. Oh. There you go. Okay. So, doesn't like these LEDs very much. So, it's pretty good. Let's see. So, let's find the layout. So, obviously with all Logitech gaming stuff, you get your music controls. So, got volume up, volume down, mute sound. And obviously all your play keys, just like on here. I'll try fit it in and get a little comparison going. So as you can see from this old one, this only had one USB, but then it also had your volume and your microphone, but whoever used that, I never used that because it's just pointless. It just made it look worse. But I have actually plugged my mouse into the back of this, and that'll give me more length on my mouse, as I know that it's coming, the power won't be coming through the keyboard and in the mouse. It's got its own separate power, so it's just like an extension USB. So first features are, you obviously got your keys here, which are very simple. They are gradually raised up, so obviously this one's shorter than this one. Got your normal keys, you have got your window keys. A lot of mechanical keyboards tend to like change this to their own special one. And then you've got your three different modes, and then your master mode for configuring. So obviously I can select that, and that's recording. That records your keys, so you can do it while you're recording, I think, pretty much. So that means you have three different keys, so you could technically do this, but you know, who's gonna go while I'm gaming? Maybe I might actually. I just said who would, but you wouldn't do it mid gaming, but you might do it for like, if I have a medic kit, my keyboards might be different from a medic and from a sniper, which I think they are actually, so on Battlefield 4. So here you've got your two buttons that are both lit up. I don't know, might be better unlit up. Yeah, a little bit. So you've got two buttons. So you've got this one, which is for your keyboard, and this one, which is for your arrows, well, your grey keys, so WASD and your arrows. So you can light them individually, you see, so they're lit up. And they've got different dimming programs, so that's cool. And then you can have them not lit, so that might help you. It's too bright for my camera to see. One more. No. One, two. So there's four different settings of dim. So yeah, pretty much a robust keyboard. There's not much I can say about it. First impressions are amazing. I really like it. Nice and sturdy. Small size. The only bit extra it's got is this. They thought about it. You know, a lot of keyboards come with your free cables, and whoever uses them, no one. And like I said, because the power had to come through this to get to these USBs, they were always underpowered. And even when you plugged it into your computer, it said try changing the ports because they're underpowered. So, if this comes direct through here, I didn't get that warning when plugging my mouse in, so can't complain there. I'm just looking forward to using this. I'm going to be useless though for the first week probably, as this, I'm used to this. You know, it's got a few extra keys, like the P's nicely raised and stuff like that. So obviously on here, P's over here, so I can't use that while I'm gaming, but we'll see. So I'll do a little overview of the software, and then I think that pretty much rounds up, because there's not much to say. It's just a really nice keyboard overall. I just love Logitech. Everything I own now is Logitech. Mouse, keyboard, camera, speakers, headset, as you'll see in a minute. Welcome back, guys. So I've got my keyboard plugged in, and I'm just going to look at the software. So it's already detected it. So once you download the software, I didn't have to install any drivers, because obviously the Logitech software, gaming software, has all the drivers ready. So no matter what you plug in, you're ready to play. So it actually didn't even take anything, didn't have to install anything extra, plugged in and it turned on straight away. As you can see, it's got the layout of the keyboard on the software. This stuff is so simple to use, I love it. So, just like anything else, you've got your default profiles. Just like for these, I think it does go across all of them. So if I added one here, cheese, description, whatever. Fuck's sake, blah blah blah. I can't even do that. Let's add one. Okay, I'll let it scan for games. So this is all the games I've not got installed. I haven't even got that installed, but yeah. So these, I've just added Team Fortress, and let's see if it goes through. So it goes through all. So the settings, no matter what you set them on, for the whole thing. So on this keyboard, all you can really set is these keys here. So, and you can't change these ones. You only can change these ones. Only program the left six. So you're a bit limited in what you can change on the Z board I had. You could change everything. Every key to a different setting, so that was really cool. But you know, there's not much need to, I don't think, anymore these days. I didn't really change them, except from on the actual gamepad, I changed some around, but that was it. So you can do all sorts, obviously. Well, there's not much for these, but for Team Fortress, there's quite a few. Look, there's like, it comes with basic commands like change class, drop briefcase. I don't play Team Fortress 2, I've just got it installed, so I don't know. It's any good or not, but whatever. So yeah, the software is simple. What I will do is I will try and type with it. So apart from that cheese, I haven't written anything else. So let's get something up. Type this. Sentences. Okay, so you can see I'm already messing up. Let's see. Mary came home. The puppy is playing with a rope. Alright, so that's the first thing I've typed on this keyboard, and I pretty much did it bang on. I don't know about capital letters, so I'll try the next bit. Bob is a baby boy, full stop. The phone fell off the shelf. Dave rang the phone to see what his mum wanted. Blah, blah, blah. I do really like this. I've noticed the keys are really close together, so, but it did seem to naturally come to me, which was quite good. So I don't know how much it would get used to gaming. I think if you came from a normal keyboard where you use WSD anyway, then you'd be alright, but it's just because I've used like the gamepad on the side that it's a bit different. I don't really know what this game mode does. I'm guessing it'll be like on the old keyboards where it stops you being able to like minimise your game by accident and stuff like that, so we'll see. I don't know if it does anything on this. You can't program it, can you? So no, but you've obviously, well, I don't know, first impressions, love it. It's so neat and tidy on my desk, I can hide that I'm a gamer. And it seems that a lot of people use it for programming as well, so hopefully it should help me write out my reports for college easier. Anyway, cheers for listening. So that pretty much sums it all up. It's a great keyboard, I'd really recommend buying it. It's nice. I may do a review later on of how it is, but I think my first impression is going to be the same as my everlasting impression. It's the bee's knees. Logitech gaming software stuff is amazing, as I've already said. I just wouldn't not have it. It's amazing. Fanboy, but it's really good quality. And I've had Razer stuff before and I was really disappointed, so this is really nice. One thing I have noticed is that the LEDs are a bit bright, but obviously you can. It's not as if you can't do anything about it, so that's not too bad. But they do seem to flicker. I don't know if that's just because I'm looking away, they seem to flicker, but I've turned them down to nearly the lowest setting. But that's the only disadvantage I can see so far.